The coronavirus pandemic started from Wuhan, and now a popular unrest against the Communist Party of China is also starting from Wuhan. If the Chinese Communist Party thought that it could surreptitiously give the world a deadly pandemic and get away with it, then it is certainly mistaken. Not only the entire world, but the people of China too are now coming down heavily on the Communist Party of China. With Chinese citizens looking to sue their local governments over the coronavirus cover-up, there is every signal of an upcoming rebellion in China that could well mean curtains for the CCP. And it is only fitting that the epicenter of the brewing anti-CCP rebellion also happens to be Wuhan, the town from where the novel coronavirus was first reported. Chinese families are accusing the Wuhan and Hubei provincial governments of hiding the COVID-19 outbreak when it first emerged late last year. The CCP has meanwhile done what it does best, killing free speech, even as Wuhan locals accuse local governments of threatening them for bringing lawsuits over the Chinese virus cover-up. A 67-year-old Wuhan resident, Zhong Hanning, who lost her son to the COVID-19 in February this year, has spilled the beans on how the CCP administration caused many deaths with its brutal cover-up that went as far as getting the World Health Organization to mislead the entire world. Hanning said, "They say the epidemic was a natural calamity, but these serious outcomes are man-made, and you need to find who's to blame." She added that, "Our family is shattered. I can never be happy again." Hanning is not the only one in Wuhan who thinks that the catastrophic pandemic wasn't entirely natural and that the culprits need to be taken to task. Hanning is really a trendsetter, and now dozens are following the brave woman in confronting the brutal CCP regime. However, those who want to sue the local governments are being coerced by the Chinese authorities not to file lawsuits. Even lawyers are reportedly being warned against suing the local governments. The Chinese Communist Party is trying to restrain Chinese citizens from filing lawsuits, but those who have lost their children, their parents, or their spouses seem relentless. Chang Hai, who lost his father to the Wuhan virus, said that at least 5 suits have been filed at the Wuhan Intermediate Court. The plaintiffs are seeking approximately 2 million yuan, which is equivalent to $295,000 in compensation from the Communist Party of China. They're also seeking an even more expensive public apology. Yang Changqing, a US-based former Chinese activist, however, said that the court has rejected the lawsuits over procedural technicalities. It doesn't really come as a surprise given how China's courts are actually serving as CCP agents and are against dispensing justice. Nevertheless, a loud and clear message has been sent across. The people of China understand how the CCP regime hid a deadly virus and sacrificed them to escape responsibility. Chinese citizens, especially the Wuhan locals, understand how the CCP fabricated test results to suppress COVID-19 numbers. In many cases, such distortions even turned fatal. It is already well known that China's COVID-19 statistics are grossly underreported given the disproportionately high numbers of body bags that were ordered and urns that were handed over when the pandemic was at its peak in China. And to top it all, it is becoming increasingly clear that the COVID-19 virus likely originated from the Wuhan lab and not an unhygienic wet market. Chinese whistleblower virologist Li Mengyang has even claimed that the coronavirus was developed in a Chinese lab, even though Beijing and the WHO continue to deny it unabashedly. But now those who were victimized by the CCP as a part of its cover-up seem to be speaking all over again. These are trappings of social unrest that seems to be brewing in China, as the Chinese nationals are now speaking up against the CCP, even though they do understand the consequences of all this. But it seems that they have had enough of the CCP's disastrous policies that are pushing their country towards devastating floods controlled by communist authorities, near famines, and sheer destitution. Chinese citizens are turning out to be the biggest victims of Chinese President Xi Jinping's belligerence. While the paper dragon is turning out to be an apathetic administrator, Beijing's external policies are also turning Chinese citizens towards destitution. As foreign companies move out of China due to Beijing's fallout with the democratic world, it is the Chinese citizens who will be staring into sheer vagrancy. At the end of the day, it is the Wuhan coronavirus that is proving to be a real provocation for the Chinese citizenry. China is therefore headed towards poetic justice. Coronavirus started from Wuhan, and the popular unrest against China is also starting from Wuhan.